I remember reading a book that somebody in a church, when we were in Germany as a posting, we went to an American Baptist church, and somebody there was teaching us about how to raise your children in a biblical way. And they gave us a book by somebody called Richard Fugate. And at the back of that book, just at the very end, he talked just a tiny bit about homeschooling. And I didn't like the idea of putting her into somebody else's hands to teach what the world basically was going to teach, especially I was concerned about teaching about homosexuality and teaching about evolution, and the separation really from her and what would be the influences on her.
Much prefer them to be at home than being in a school where we can't see what they're being taught. They're mature as they are at home, being home educated, and they, you know, they say what lovely children you have and they're well behaved, but of course, you know, they're not always well behaved because we live in this fleshly body, don't we? So, but we do get a lot of positive comments from people.
I do believe that we are accountable to God for the way that we raise our children. Mm. I think it's worth homeschooling to have the godly training of our children, to be able to talk about the Lord with them in the daytime and to have a godly influence upon them rather than an ungodly influence, to give them the Lord's view on things rather than the world's view, to have that open relationship with our children so that they know what we're like, they know, yeah, they see us as we are, and we can be close and talk to them about just life.
All of a sudden their child's gone, you know, from the house, and they're not going to see them possibly until, well, 4 o'clock maybe, you know, later maybe. And if Emma's married, if the Lord wants her to get married, and she has children, then I would want to see her homeschooling as well. So it can have been a generational thing as well. It can affect the next generation.
I would say, see what relationship you can have with your children if you're at home with them all the time, and then compare that to what you would have if you were just seeing them before they left for school and then when they got home in the evening and they were tired. And
I mean, I was in the army for 22 years. I was trained to be a soldier, and I had to go through that training. It was only 9 weeks basic training. I mean, we're training our children right through up to when they graduate. But it says, you know, if you train up your children, they won't depart from it, and that's a promise.